Okay, you don't actually have to answer me on that, but do give me, dreadful, better. I can't even stand to look at myself, because why would I? Why would I want to look at myself like this, where I look frumpy? Look at how it changes the shape of my neck. Suddenly I have this big honking head and this little old lady icky neckline, and suddenly the print, we talked about prints earlier, suddenly the print looks matronly. Whereas if I take this and go off the shoulder, suddenly this is cool. My head doesn't look quite so large. The print is more interesting because I have a diagonal line to offset it. Cool. Yeah. I want to just go like the Vulcan mind meld to all of you, but I can't. I don't know the Vulcan mind meld. I'm sure there's a trick to it. Okay, I want to go to share screen. All right, all three of these pictures are dresses made by one of my So Like a Pro members, Tammy. We were in Phoenix, Arizona. They were all filmed on the same day, within hours. I mean, we had a marathon filming session. I filmed three blogs wearing three separate dresses. I filmed extra videos for the sewing school, all sorts of stuff. Look how different my body looks in all three of these. Okay, now I want you all to chat in either the Zoom or in Facebook. Tell me which one is your favorite. Just say purple, beige, or white. We'll just call it purple, beige, or white. Say which one is your top choice and why. Or some people can't think in terms of good. So what is your least favorite and why? Or you can do both. Time's up on that. Now, I'm the exact same size. Obviously, I didn't gain weight or lose weight in that same day. So first of all, the color on this one, because there is so much flesh color that doesn't match my skin, I haven't read your comments yet. Automatically, the beige one loses in the color department. If I were the same color as the dress, it would look significantly better. Okay, so color default, even though red is great on me, it's one of my colors, there is not enough red up close to my face to make this dress a good color choice. White is okay. I mean, it looks fine, but I'm so pale that the white barely shows up. So hands down, color-wise, the purple is the best. It is all three of these are in my color palette. So this makes this even more fascinating, because it's not like I'm wearing pale pink where I would look dead. These are all good colors for me. So purple wins color-wise. Now let's look at my back. Let's start with my back. Because which of these three backs is most flattering? Actually, because there could be a tie. That could be a matter of opinion. Chat in the box, if you would, please. What is your least favorite of these backs and why? So again, we're doing a dress analysis. So same person, three different dresses. Now, ladies, whenever you go to the store and you try on tops, or you try on dresses, or evening gowns, or pantsuits, or whatever, these are the kind of details that you're going to look for on yourself, because you're doing a case study on yourself, basically. Okay, so this is sort of your final session for knowledge, your final awareness assignment. All right, now I'm gonna tell you my personal opinion on this, because hopefully you're all about finish now. Hands down, the beige dress, again, is absolutely horrible, because this scoop on me makes me look much, much heavier than in the other two dresses. It's not a good shape for me. It goes straight across at the waist, and it makes me look very meaty and thick up here. This dress is the best because these diagonal lines help break up the fact that I could potentially look thick around here. So these two horizontal lines are fabulous. I could also do a third one going up towards my shoulder. That would not be a bad thing. So that's one way for you to help customize an inspiration dress, is add little things to make it your own. Also, this particular dress with the drape covers any of my natural curves, which show pretty nicely in the purple dress and very well on the white dress. So this drape is awful on me. So there's a lot of reasons this doesn't work. And there's so much going on this dress that is in the wrong place on me. It also just makes me look horizontal and horizontal. And then this line for my height is not steep enough. So if we talk about skirts for a moment, these two angles, the purple angle is actually about the same angle as the flesh colored. Really, this is not steep enough on me. The white is a much steeper skirt angle, which makes my legs look much better because I have a longer line where the bottom of this fringe is. Also, I have a very long line that goes all the way from shoulder to hip to down. So this has a lot, especially on the back view of this dress, a lot of great visual length that makes me look a lot taller and slimmer. Okay, is all this making sense? All these little nuances are what you're going to look for. Your final assignment is not necessarily something that you can do between now and, you know, like over the next couple days. It could take a while unless you have a lot of costumes in your closet. If you have a lot of costumes in your closet, or a lot of evening gowns, or a lot of pantsuits, and you can actually look at yourself like this, head to toe, then go ahead and do the assignment and post it. That would be fabulous. All right, the purple one over here from the back view, because right here I look really feminine, but still sexy. So for me, that's a very good combination. I mean, I'm 50 standing here in this picture, and I was super nervous about going on camera looking like this because I had not worn this little clothing on in public in a very long time. And then when I went back and looked at the pictures, I was like, oh, I look pretty damn good. So that's one of those things where with awareness comes compassion. And then I loved that I had these three assignments here. So this particular round back opening here would be second choice. When you're looking at yourself or inspiration dresses or anything, it is usually easier to choose the best and the worst first. How your brain works is what you see first, or sometimes it's what stands out. Sometimes the best is so much better than the rest, you're like, oh, that's definitely the best. Sometimes the worst is so bad that you're like, oh yeah, that one is really horrible. This is definitely the worst. And then you have to search for the best. Okay, does that make sense? But always try to find something on opposite ends of the spectrum, because that's the easiest for the human brain to accept and to recognize. And then you can work your way towards the middle. So that's why I'm trying to ask you one or the other, what's the best or the worst, not what's the middle of the road one. Because the middle of the road, you're going to go, well, what's the middle? You know, that's not going to work. So as you were looking for inspiration dresses, as you are becoming more aware of what looks good on you and what doesn't, opposite ends is always the way to go. Work your way back. Now, so if I continue talking about these three dresses from this particular view, this also has a very similar three-dimensional flower as to this dress, but because it is placed at such a horrible spot on my body, it again is detracting. Whereas the flowers here along my hip do a great job of accentuating my hip curve. And because there's just a little bit of volume here, it actually makes my waist look a little tinier because there is contrast between some three-dimensional flowers and a waist that is actually pretty straight these days. That might be all the curve I have. Okay, does that make sense? On this side, on the back, the high collar is, the skirt length is not great. It's not steep enough on the purple one. This particular accent that goes down towards the skirt is really fabulous because it makes me look taller. It gives the viewer's eye. The best thing about this purple one from the back view is that all of these rhinestones up at the neck lead the viewer's eye to run straight down towards the bottom of the skirt. So in doing that, it helps create a visual line. But what breaks up that visual line is this big old circle in the middle. So this on me, this is not the best shape because while I need to look taller and the stones and the fringe kind of do that, this is the shape chops it. So this would be better for someone who's taller than me where looking longer is not a priority. Okay, does all that make sense on the back? Give me a thumbs up, give me a chat. Let me see if I can see the chat here with any questions on the back of that before we move on to the front.
This is Edie. I have a question about the back of the purple. I love the back of the neck, but to me it looked, part of why it looked to me that you look more meaty there was, which of course is insane because you're not, is the, it seems like the width of the shoulder. Had it been a tighter, haltery look, I think might have been better. Am I wrong?
No, I think that's a good assessment. We'll go back to it. Okay, nope, that is a really good assessment because a lot of women don't, this is another reason not to wear cap sleeves. This is very close to a cap sleeve. And a lot of women have meat back here, you know, right where the sleeve hits it. I was swimming a whole lot at the time, so my arms are in really, everything's in really pretty good condition at this point in time. But most women don't, especially older women, I should say, don't look good with cap sleeves for the same reason, because it digs in like that one, kind of digs in. And then cap sleeves do the same thing. Also, this makes me look very broad because it's so open, it's just broad. So no, that was a very good point. All right, cool. Let's move on to the, hang on, let me check Facebook real quickly before we move on to the front. Okay, let's, wait, where did my, I'm like, wait, where did the internet go on? Let's see here, what is my favorite? It's a couple of straps. Okay, all right, so nobody's necessarily, they're a few minutes lag behind Zoom. All right, let's go back to the front. Cool. Now, those of you who've been with me for several master classes, I've never actually shown these pictures. So this is the first time. All right. So we have head to toe. I don't want that much. I just want a little bit. There we go. All right. So we have head to toe. Again, if you would in the box, so not even thinking about the back, put in the chat what you think the best front is and why, or the worst and why. But again, you could do both. And I'm gonna play music even though Facebook's gonna mute it on the recording. Okay, time's up. All right, so anybody want to do a shout out on Zoom? Unmute yourself and say which dress you think is the favorite and why.
I will. I really like the white on you. I think the front of it looks great. You look very, very fit. And so I think all the sort of cutaway pieces, the neckline of the white really shows off your tone. And I said earlier, you look like you're ready for the award.
The white one certainly makes me look I think it does highlight some good areas, because at the time my abs are like awesome from swimming so much. And the fact that it has a dense cluster of shoulder or dense cluster of flowers up on the shoulder, and then a dense cluster of flowers down at the hips helps keep the viewer's eye doing a long line without needing an entire row of flowers. So you know that psychology behind, they'll have you read a sentence and they'll just occasionally leave words out, but the mind will fill in the sentence to be what it should be versus the words that are left out. You know what I'm talking about? Or if you see a picture of a dog and there's maybe only one third of the dog is actually drawn in this outline, you know that it's a dog because your mind fills in the rest of it. So designing is kind of like that also, in that here, there is literally, design wise, there is a long line of red, even though there is not an entire line of red. Does that make sense? The human eye will fill in and go, oh, whoop, I just created a long visual line, even though there's not enough flowers there. Does that make sense? So as you're designing, you can use that to your advantage. Whereas over here, there is clearly, I think as far as where do I look tall, I think I look the tallest in the purple, hands down, because it goes all the way from the top of my neck down to the bottom of the skirt. This is not a good length on me. I would look better if the sides of this were higher, so that it made my legs look longer. But as far as height goes, I'm definitely the tallest in the purple. And then this big old honking row of rhinestones further reinforces that. Now look at this dress. Oh my gosh, I was crushed when she asked me to wear this dress. She had like 10 dresses there that day. And I said, just pick ones out, let me know what you want me to wear. And these were the first two that she asked me to wear. And then she wanted me to put that one on. And I really didn't want to wear it. It's an absolutely horrible neckline on me. This horizontal belt going around the middle is not good. It just chops me off. There's all these, the volume of the skirt and the gathers is not good on me. But in hindsight, I'm really glad she did, because now we have this awesome tutorial.